Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Let's clap hands for Jesus. I'm grateful to be given this opportunity to worship. If you can stand, you may stand up and stand and raise up your hands, raising hands as a sign of surrender. We are surrendering the one who created us. Let me tell you this, we are going to worship God. We are going to worship the powerful God. We are going to honor the God who heals you. We are going to honor the God who is able. We are going to honor the God who is the answer. We are going to honor God who has love, unconditional love soul. We are going to honor the God who is powerful.
Thank you,
Jesus. We are going to honor God. We are going to honor God who was here long before today. When you and I were not created, this God was alive. We are going to honor him, the one who talks and do. We are going to honor God, the one who looks and it happens. We are going to honor God, the one who lives. We are going to honor him, the one who is the Savior. We are going to honor him, the one who is the fighter. Thank you, Jesus. We're going to the Psalm 100.
Verse 2.
It says worship. To worship God in happiness. Oh, thank you, Jesus. You cannot honor God while you are still holding on to your sickness. You forget about your sickness. You forget about the pain you are feeling. You forget about the poverty. Forget about whatever that you want. You forget. And you worship God when you are in happiness. Worship God in happiness. You cannot worship him when you are listening to your pain. It needs you and I to be happy. It needs you and I to forget. It needs you and I to forget about everything. It needs you and I to focus on him. It needs you and I not to hear ourselves. It needs you and I not to hear our bodies. For us to worship God in happiness, to go in his presence, go to his presence in happiness. When you are happy, God wants us to praise him. When we are happy, he wants our praise. When we are happy, he doesn't want us crying. He doesn't want us crying. He wants us happy, so that we can praise him. You cannot praise him. This God, if you are not happy, it needs you and I being happy. It needs us to be happy, so that we can give him praise. So that you can give him honor and say, God, indeed be holy. Oh God, oh be lifted. Oh God, oh be lifted. Oh God, be lifted. Oh Father, we thank you.
Thank you. Okay, drop. Yeah. Somebody clap us for Jesus. Clap us for God. Yes, Lord.
We may be seated in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
Greet you all in the wonderful name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Firstly, greeting the mother of the house.
Amen. The prophetess of the house.
Let's clap for her in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's also greet the voice cancer.
Let's clap for them.
Love them so much. Let me also greet organizing committee. So we love them so
let's
much.
Let's clap for them.
Honored to have you. And also greet the worshiping team. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ashara. Banana. Bafumakazi.
Men and women in our midst.
Bason.
Youth.
Children ministry.
Natural ministry. Clap hands for yourself.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's a wonderful day. That the Lord has made. I love God who is in this place. I love God who is in you. Amen.
Amen.
Kaba bena neighbori. My apostle lover of Funam Zimore Cabon.
Say to your neighbor, the apostle says he loves the God that is in you.
Abambena bofu tibare mo apostle lover of Funam Zimore Cabon.
Say it again, say, apostle love the Lord that is in you.
Amen.
Amen.
Because you are God.
We are getting there because Narum Zim
is doing it for you. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Again, greet your neighbor. Greet your neighbor. Greet your neighbor. Say neighbor. 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 You are beautiful. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Even what she wears, tell them that they are beautiful.
Amen.
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 It's beautiful in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
I hope
they are fulfilled
and pray.
Now Rabbi,
and believe so.
Now tender.
This should be my last Sunday.
Or he that you have a young
girl.
As I'm fellowshipping in this place like
amen.
This.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hey, I mean me. Say
the apostle is saying himself.
Amen.
Amen. We are going straight to the word of God in this afternoon.
If it happens, may fire not catch me this afternoon. Because I want to just speak to you. In other ways,
he wants to encourage you.
But if fire comes,
I will
move with the fire. But I pray this afternoon that fire may not catch me.
Because
he wants
to encourage you.
We can preach and do anything. But we
need the Sunday of encouragement.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Luke chapter 13, verse 1 to 5.
Luke chapter 13.
Say the apostle wants to encourage us in the Lord.
Luke chapter 13.
Luke chapter 13.
Verse 1 to 5. It reads, about this time Jesus was informed that Pilate had murdered some people from Galilee as they were offering sacrifice at the temple. Do you think those people, those Galileans were worse sinners than all the other people from Galilee? Jesus asked, is that why they suffered? Not at all. And you will perish too unless you repent of your sins and turn to God.
And what about the 18 people who died when the tower in Siloam fell on them? Were they worst sinners in Jerusalem? No. And I tell you again that unless you repent, you will perish too.
Zonezo, vangwe batu, bebaba, behenefo, babuta yeso, zwe pilato aita, achi buraha, bagalelia, musibachiko, tabela mzimu, zindubu, atanganya marofa abo, nandubu zabo. Yeso achi mafundura ari, nivonunga abo, bagalelia, bachuburawa, nga uralo nige baba, bebone bachinyo fira batu bote bagalelia na nakati niri nasare mburuwa nitoroba note ufana nabu niri mininga wala wa 18 basilo beba chakiwa nga mucheto wa wavuraha nivononga nivone beba kakela mtimu fira vangwe batura wa Jerusalema na nakati Nendiri, nasare mburuwa, nitoroba note ufana naamu. Karela bele, wawuruga, zimu wa chirizi, zimu wa mutu, zimu wa madembe. Ani afurufetea ni iwe, auna mungwe nganda wone, zimu wanga amba na rinerote. Na nanote cherensa, hile fi mzimu wanga lo mfanira. Ibana sunia mzimu wanga wa shuru, uchitera, machiru ashu. Uchitela mzimuanga vanabashumrena uchitela na rine uchilomune na uchila zinani la manda la mrena Yesu Kristo kukumetela mrezo yuote panda shoto chavo nishere mrena kaba jenda angu saizuro temba na ufulufe na wone na wone ba mzimu nga zina lina la vantama zina ote zina la Yesu roteri amen Romana Pugu Ya Luke.
We read the book of Luke.
Ine yongwaniwa nga ene muno Luke.
That has been written by Luke himself.
In actual fact, he's a doctor.
E wendela ni mtakatayo.
He's a physician doctor.
Ni mtakatayo wa marambo.
Adoba futi aba ene associate of Paul.
Then oba takanyelela na Paulo.
Nga wendela oba amu wa mshumisani na Paulo.
In other words, they have companion with Paul.
And hangopela hapo mtakatayo fetzi ya marambo.
He not end as a physician doctor.
Adoba futi aba a journalist.
Atala aba a journalist hapo.
Nga wendela oba aramafungu.
He was a journalist. When he read this book, he was gathering the information from people who have seen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Say to your neighbor,
Luke was a physician doctor.
Luke was a doctor. He was a companion of Paul. And he was a journalist. Now in 1860, he's recording this news. When people telling Pilato, Jesus, what Pilato has done.
Pilato aita, kama Galilea.
What Pilato has done to the Galileans. As they were sacrificing. When they were making a sacrifice to God,
Pilato
killed them. He's killing people who are sacrificing for God. Who are serving God. Who are doing the right thing before the presence of God. But the Bible says Pilate killed them. When they were talking to Jesus, the Bible says Jesus said to them, do you think the Galileans were the worst sinners? There are people who are living where the Galileans were killed. But some other people are committing sin. But they are not killed. Are they worse sinners than other people? Do you think they are more than the
18?
Those the tower fell on them. In the silo. Do you think those people? They are worse sinners than others. But there's another statement that he has used. One statement twice. That said, repent. If you not repent, you will perish like them.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He said repent. If you not repent, you will perish like them. Say to your neighbor, let's repent. So that we cannot perish like that.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Now I want to teach you this.
When bad things
happen
to good people,
it's like God is nowhere. Are you hearing this? Those people that were sacrificing for God, they are doing good things before God, but bad things happen on them. They are doing good things. When they were doing good things, bad things happen. When they were done, people have something to say that they can tell to Jesus. That Pilate did this to people who were sacrificing for God. That it tells that they were unfaithful. Sometimes you can go to church, but you are unfaithful. You can fellowship at church, but you're not living the right way. Now, there are people who are living, but they're not living the right life. But that they are not being punished. The one that you are going to church, it's like we are full of troubles and challenges. It's like when the one who are sick, then the others who are outside. Sometimes we brought challenges in the church. After there are people that are enjoying. So the apostle is talking to you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen. Are you hearing this? These people, as they are sacrificing, as what happened, they were killed. Were they not living the right life? They were living the right life. But when they were living right, bad things happened to them.
When bad things happen to good people,
it's like that God is nowhere. They are outside. As you are living, when our things are not going for us, people that think, where is your God? Amen. We have been named. They have said many things. It's like our God is nowhere. But there are people that are going. There are things that are going well. It's like God is nowhere. It's not like that. Is it not true?
Hallelujah.
Amen. When it happened, people, they think the God that we serve, they, something that Jesus said. He said, have peace in me. So they're out there doing the war
around.
Have troubled me. Has still made me to suffer. Waiting in this world, you have to understand something. You are the ambassador in this world. Don't expect the world to favor you, because you are not of this world. When it happens because you want to be like them, when the people of this world are good, you want to give up and leave the church.
Amen.
The 18 with the tower fell on them. We pray, but after praying with
God,
mighty God, it doesn't mean God is still there. Jesus was crucified. What was he doing when he was crucified? He was saving. He was defending. He was faithful. He was praying to people. He was healing people. He was preaching the way. But they crucified him.
Amen.
Are you hearing this?
He
can do a good thing to a people. The very same people that you have duped.
And if we are abatela nga shutu zune za sibe swamudi.
Man pay you with bad things.
Famu itera, vachiko shifuna. Achimobuya ari, vaya ditisa nito wa sumeza. Vati chonga wane vaya kono pwesa vatu.
Mighty Jesus. Hey.
Wane mo shuitanga lufuna.
You did with love.
Mo shuitanga vachiko shifuna.
You did with love.
Maraba wana mutu, wane wane mamu itera chitu.
But you find the person that you have helped.
Achimuya futa daba wisa. It's better I have to go outside. Then you try and nothing happens. When bad things happen to good people,
You work, we work
on our work.
Almighty
God. And they compliment another person. Mighty Jesus.
Yes,
you are the one who was working. Why this God cannot be seen? The problems can come and say that God is not
working.
Amen. As you are done fasting for the money that you do, I have to build with this money. Then the big problem came after
fast.
That takes the money that you want to build with. As you have fasted. Say to your neighbor, the apostle is speaking. Where is this God? How many people question
me?
I'm serving him, I'm looking for a job, but I don't find a job. I served him, I was faithful to him. I have never received what I have desired. In my life, I'm just trying, pushing.
John.
I'm trying. Where is this God?
Where is this God?
Amen.
And then I shall go.
Even the world.
Love say,
they laugh. It's a fellowship. Mighty God. Sometimes even a relative laughs. Those who are close to you, they are just going to the church. Mighty God.
Praise be to God.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I
and it looks like God is still away. But God is still here.
Amen.
Even today he's still here. Even today he's still here. There is something that you have to encounter. Stand up and move forward. Hold on. And never leave. It's for you to give up. It's for you to get tired. It's for you to say that God is nowhere. It's mighty God.
Amen.
Mighty Jesus. You're not hearing this.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
The head was the one. You will never believe the second one. You will need the third one. That's what the devil wants. Mighty God. We receive nothing as you are serving God. And there's a second group. Those who are fearing God, taking to themselves. Then the God listens.
Eh?
Amen.
The person doesn't help to serve God. It doesn't help to be a good
person.
It doesn't help to be a kindness people. So the second one they were talking, God listened to them. He listened to them. When he listened to them, they said, the book was written. There's a book that has been written. For the Ryan who are living right. For the good people. And then, in other day, it shall be seen from the bed in the good
people.
It's still encountering the challenge. It's experiencing the things of God. It looks as God is nowhere. But the book has been written. It shall be revealed.
What
the good and the bad.
What
the good people. The book of
Job chapter 1. Job.
The book of Job.
You can open it.
Bagay food.
Open it.
Kabay food.
Verse 20.
The Bible says.
Yopo.
Job.
Where are you from?
Who was faithful?
Where you from? So come and be the neighbor.
Say to your neighbor.
Your boy was from Peter.
Job was faithful.
Hey, hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says.
Verse 20. Your boy honor of anyone, the one.
When his children died. Job was faithful and was fearing God.
Honor of anyone.
After his children died. Mighty God, think of me while my children are dead. After his children died, he was so rich. They took everything from him. In verse 20, Job stood up. And he tears off his clothes. He even take off his hair. Because he was in pain. Then he fell down with his face. Then he said, I came from out my mother's
house
with nothing. Then I will go back with nothing. God has given. God has taken.
It's your panda.
So it goes further. Then Job.
Now,
even the danger came to him. He did not say anything to God.
Jesus.
Are you hearing this? Even though he was hurt like this, he didn't say anything to God. He never said anything to God. And when things happened, and the problem came, when his children were dead, when they took everything from him, and he was left with his wife, he never said anything. What did you say?
Yeah?
Hey. What do you say? The Bible says, Job never said anything.
Hey, I'm gonna cheat.
Yes, yeah. He didn't say anything.
Wafuna.
Love. They love so much.
Asafune.
Then they don't love you.
Uh-huh. Call me.
And live with callbacks. Say, I was busy. Hey. You call him in the night?
Yeah,
it goes straight to the
voice.
My just out of bedroom.
Jesus. Jesus.
Why is that?
You made full things to your children. You build a beautiful house.
Oh my God.
Mighty God.
Huh?
You have a snake.
I'm a different one.
Yeah.
And the people they are looking at
you.
When they see you, they see a snake.
Yeah.
As you are serving him, God. Praying to God wholeheartedly, holding the Bible always. The world knows
you.
The Bible. They know you from a snake. Mighty God. As you are working with your hands,
when bad things happen to good people,
what do you say? Do you say this God is
like
the Bible says Job never said anything. What is needed on you and me is to repent on problems when we encounter them.
It's
to repent when we encounter challenges.
Our language is
when
we
say to your neighbor.
Neighbor.
So that's him. Hello.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What about Sura?
When you are sitting, God can defend for you. Just counter, he came and go. You're always countering where you've passed. You even counter the job. You are countering everything. You are always counting. Even though you are still counting the church that you have
found.
They prayed in me here. And I go this and this. Even today I have found nothing. Repent your languages and your thoughts.
Amen.
Repent. God didn't say challenges will not come. Paul says, when I want things to come, they found me in him.
Amen.
When God says, when you enter into the fire, he said, I will make it to pass in the
fire.
He said, when you get into the fire, I will get with you. We have to get in the fire and
defend.
If you are burning, God is dead. When we go from the fire, we get into the water. I will allow you to go into the water. Then I will be there also. You will live in the water. He will take us out. It doesn't matter how time is taking. How many years was taken for the people of Israel to go to Canaan?
40 years.
40 years.
40 years.
You have years that you can counter. Sometimes you have been troubled by the children that you've given birth to. Can you give birth to your child, then you make them to go to school? It's better
that.
Mighty God, as you fed the child, you even teach the love, the children to the
love.
They have to speak in this way. Then they brought another language from the outside. Then they speak the vulgar words to you. This child will work and take you higher. They put you down.
Hey, where you find the H? Talk to your neighbor and say, neighbor.
But it's not in it. What do you say when you encounter those things?
Do we say God is not there?
But it's how? Amen.
But how?
Do you say God is not there?
Lord, where are you?
Where are you?
Abraham.
Abraham.
He
was 90 years without a child.
Eh?
Is it not true? Ask your neighbor, don't you know this?
Acts chapter 7.
Female apostle and the male summit.
57.
The Bible says.
Stephanie.
Say, after I have seen the heaven open. After he said that I have seen the heaven open. People, they were shouting. They even closed their ears for nothing to go forward. They take him outside and they stoned him.
And
they were stoning him. I love Stephanie.
Do
not insult them. Said my father, receive my spirit. Can you say that? And they were stoning him. When they stone you, you take those things and you take them back. When they insult you, you insult back. When they gossip you, you approach. When they talk bad things to you, you phone. When they talk bad things about you, we heard that you go there. You are there, you even brought the news. Might you even set the fire? You are even setting the fire more. When bad things happen in your life, so it wants you when you are repenting. Has it found you? When these things come to us, they may find you repenting. Where do you repent? If you shall not repent, you will perish. Repent, do not repent, you can kill. If you don't repent, you will die. May
Jesus.
If you find a person for you, they go, they left you with the sickness, repent and serve God. I will serve you with my sickness. I will serve you with what I
have.
If he came and brought a child and go, mighty God, give that name. Serve God with that child that you are left with. Amen. After Stephanie said, my Abba Father, forgive them, they don't know what they are doing. As you are repented, let me help you. As you are repented, it helps you. Not to take things personally. Well, God will fight for you. If things come and find you while you are not repentant, God cannot fight. Because you are able to fight for yourself.
Amen.
Amen. But if a person fights against you and go, he said, I will buy a car for you. Just make you wait, meet with you some other day holding the keys. It's not important for you to see that person. They have to see you.
Jesus.
Hello. Amen. Amen. You want to be loved with your relative and never love you? You cry, you want to be loved. Love your children, it's okay.
Yeah.
Love those who love you. Be close to those who want to be close to you. The one who sees the importance of you. Be next to that person. The one that goes and you cry, it does not help with anything.
Hey.
I don't know these people of this world. I have known. I know that he will call me. He said he wants me, he has called me 5 times. It can never happen on another
day.
And then he catch me. But there is God in everything. Amen. There is God. Say you want to leave church. Amen. Mighty God. Even back here, give you a weapon to attack us.
Yeah,
mighty God.
Jesus!
Amen.
If you want to be a good people, mighty God. As I'm helping you, said the apostle knows that if I'm not in church, it can never go well. And there's nothing much that you're doing in church. If we don't repent, we will die. Let's get ready for the Lord. The Bible says, Stephanie said, receive my spirit. Receive my spirit. What is important is the presence of God. It's the greatness of God. I will never forsake you. When I encounter problems, yes, I even face the challenges. When I face them, he said he never left us. Let's call upon him, he will leave.
Amen.
Amen. I remember another scripture. I will not die. I will not die. I will live.
Enjoy the day. Why on tender?
Because why
did you
say that?
There's something that is cooking.
Who are picking what
pot to
be found?
Let
it go. He won't let it go.
Jesus.
Say
to your neighbor, we have to get into the fire so that I can be well. Then I can behave just what
you
say.
You say,
my things take this year. Mighty God.
My house
has been 10 years
without roofing.
Without roofing.
Mara, you were eating at the picky one and be like,
yeah,
you're
eating in his own way.
Yes. Jesus. Yeah.
Ureta.
Be late.
Asya musika.
That's not me with the left hand.
Ureta, asya musika.
That's not me
with the left hand. No, let's
even a cheery. But it's
20. Unemera, asama suahalo.
Jesus, my God, I was